beyond that which is known to man. It is a dimension as vast as space and as timeless as infinity. It is the middle ground between light and shadow, between science and superstition, and it lies between the pit of man's fears and the summit of his knowledge. This is the dimension of imagination. It is an area which we call the Twilight Zone.
Here's a computer which you've seen in the background of many of my videos over the years, and I've done several videos using it, so I figured it's time to do a video about it. This is the Tandy 1000RL, introduced in July 1990, designed to compete with the IBM PS1, which was IBM's new home market computer, sort of a low-end companion to the PS2 series. And also a couple months later, Apple introduced their home market Macintosh, the LC, which was also a competitor to this, although a bit more expensive. This was the original advertisement for it in the 1991 Radio Shack catalog. It actually earned the Good Housekeeping seal of approval, and they said success guaranteed. You can see how they were pitching it towards home use, because all the ads for it showed it being used by a woman in a kitchen. And it came with Tandy's graphical DeskMate user interface. 1990 was also the year that Microsoft introduced the Windows 3.0 graphical environment, which was the first successful version of Windows, so this went head-to-head against that. And obviously Windows won, but DeskMate did enjoy a bit of popularity at the time in Tandy's line of computers. I think they released updates on it until 1993 or so, is when they finally gave in and started putting Windows on their computers. Original price was quite low, $599.95, but that did not include a hard drive or a monitor. The version with a 20 megabyte hard drive was $999.95. They also gave you a real-time clock of battery backup, which the non-hard drive version did not have. It was also possible to get a version with two floppy drives and no hard drive, but there's only two drive bays, so you're limited to either one floppy drive and one hard drive, or two floppies. And this was Tandy's first desktop computer, did not have a built-in 5 1/4 inch drive bay, because 3 1/2 inch disks were becoming more popular at the time. It was possible to get an external 5 1/4 inch floppy drive which connected to the parallel port, but I've never seen one of those, so I don't think they sold many of those. This is a 720K drive. The following model after this, 1000RLX, did have a 1.44 megabyte floppy drive. This uses an AMD 8086 chip running at 9.54 megahertz, so it is an XT class system. By 1990, XT class systems were becoming quite obsolete. But the DeskMate software provided by Tandy does not require a powerful CPU to run, so it's still quite fast. This is the CM11 CGA monitor. It was also available with the CM5, which was a cheaper monitor with a larger dot pitch and no anti-glare coating. That's one of the nice things about this monitor. You can see the anti-glare coating makes the reflections a lot less visible. You can compare that to the monitor which came with the Apple IIgs, and it's a lot more like a mirror because it does not have that anti-glare coating. So I'll turn it on here. First turn on the monitor and let it warm up. And turn on the computer. This one has been upgraded with a 40 megabyte hard drive, but otherwise it's all original. And it starts right up into DeskMate. Now this does have MS-DOS 3.3 and the core DeskMate files in ROM, so even if you did not have the hard drive, it will be able to start up like this without needing a boot disk. Although not all the DeskMate files are in ROM, so in order to run applications like the music and sound programs or the home organizer, you would need to use a disk. But since this has a hard drive, it's ready to go right here. And since this was intended for home use, I'll show you the home organizer. And as personal, kitchen, and financial applications here. You can have a travel planner, which I've never actually used before. 7-day Caribbean cruise, things to pack. Okay, quite interesting. I guess if you go on a vacation, you could use this to write out all the things you're going to do on each day. So you can edit the text here. So this is just a sample. Things to pack, gym shorts and shirt, aerobic shoes, swimsuit, suntan lotion, sunglasses, books, tie belt, dark socks. I think you shouldn't need a computer to tell you what kind of clothes you need to pack on a cruise. So it's really just a gimmick. So let's look at one of the more useful applications here. You can put your cookbook on this computer. This is all the sample files it comes with. Let's look at the summer fruit bowl. And it lists all the ingredients and all the instructions. And since this came with a Good Housekeeping seal of approval, it makes sense that the recipes are from Good Housekeeping cookbook, page 428. Probably the 1990 version. So, kind of interesting. And here's some of the financial stuff. Checkbook register. You can create a password or leave no password, so I'll do no password. You must create a checking account before entering checks. So you get the idea. You can type in your information and you can keep the log of your checkbook on the computer. Here's the information center. You can put important phone numbers. You can put your some messages on the clipboard here, and you have a notepad. So obviously a kitchen themed application. And over here is a button for a PC link, which was the predecessor to AOL, America Online, asking you to register Quantum Computer Services. Now they had a service called Q-Link, which was aimed at Commodore 64 users, but this was the PC version called PC Link, so you could sign up using DeskMate here on your Tandy. You would need to use an optional modem. There is one card slot in the main unit, so you can install an internal modem, or you can hook up an external one to the serial port. It came with text, which was DeskMate's word processor. You can see it can display different styles of text on the screen since it is a graphical user interface. And it does come with a spell checker, so if I misspell a word here, like I'll spell test with two S's, if I go to edit and then proof, it picked up that misspelled word and lets me change it to the correct spelling. And I believe it also comes with a thesaurus. Although it was optional, so I say, see your store or dealer for more information on obtaining this program. Now the Tandy 1000 series, beginning with the 1000 SL and TL models in 1988, had a 8-bit digital to analog converter sound chip built in, and this model also had that. So it is able to play and record digital audio and also playback music. Now I'll go into the music program here. Just click on one of the files right on the desktop there, and it loads it up into the music program. And you can change these notes and make your own songs, and you can choose instruments, and you can use that sound recorder to record your own instruments. So we'll play this song here. It takes a little bit to compile it. And any second now, start playing. can hear the different instruments on there. There is a volume control on the back for the built-in speaker, and also a jack for hooking up an external speaker. And here's the sound program, which lets you record and playback digital audio files. This is the piano sample, which is used by the music program to play the piano sound. And you can edit the digital audio. You can select a certain range here, select the whole thing, and reverse it. So now we'll have a backwards piano. Play that. And switch it back the original way. We can change the amplification, do like 0.5 to make it quieter. And it also featured data compression. Now this was not like MP3 or anything like that, but it was able to make the sound files a bit smaller at the expense of quality. And on the setup screen, you can see a little sample of how it's able to do 16 colors in the 640 by 200 graphics mode, which was one of the advanced features that Tandy had. It was their enhanced version of CGA, which became very popular in PC games in the late 80s and early 90s, Tandy sound and graphics. Now let's exit the DOS here. And this comes with MS-DOS 3.3. And you can see this is actually split up into multiple partitions, since this version of DOS does not allow partitions greater than 32 megabytes. So I have a C drive for the DOS and DeskMate software. The D drive is actually the ROM drive. So you can see those are the basic startup files that are in ROM. See, it's a ROM drive because it's 0 bytes free. And if I go to E, that's the second partition of the hard drive, and I have some more programs on there. Here's a demo which uses the advanced sound and graphics capabilities of the Tandy 1000 series. Are you using a Tandy PC Junior? Yes. Music setup is Tandy. Graphics is Tandy. That's it. This is the original keyboard the Tandy 1000RL came with. It is a clicky keyboard, but it's much quieter and softer than the IBM Model M keyboard. So it still has a very nice feel to it, but it won't wake up your neighbors, unlike the IBM. I believe this was made by Fujitsu, and Tandy just put their name on it. And one nice thing is that the indicator lights are in the keys themselves, like numlock and scroll lock and caps lock. Now, to show you how small the 1000RL is compared to other PCs of the time, this is the model it replaced, the 1000SL. So you can see the comparison of size side by side there. In terms of hardware, obviously this one gives you a space to install a 5 1/4 inch floppy drive, and it has more expansion slots inside, and has a slightly slower processor. This has an 8086 running at 8 MHz, while this runs it at 9.54 MHz. But the one thing I like about this that I wish the 1000RL had carried over is the front panel controls here. You get a reset button, you get a microphone jack, an earphone jack, and a volume control for the built-in speaker and for the earphone jack. Now, all this is on the back of a 1000RL, which I'll show you right now. Actually, first, you can see all the cooling vents on the side. That's because this model does not have a built-in fan. So if you had the version without the hard drive, it would run totally silently. Now here is the back of the computer. You can see there's one sideways 8-bit ISA expansion slot and a bunch of built-in ports. There's a 9-pin serial port, there's two Tandy 1000 joystick ports, there's the earphone and microphone jacks, the volume control, and that's actually a stereo earphone jack, even though the built-in speaker and the sound capability is only mono. Down there is the monitor port, which not only supports CGA monitors, you can also switch it into monochrome mode and use it with an MDA monitor, which would also give you 720 by 348 Hercules graphics, which DeskMate also supports. There's the parallel printer port and the PS2 keyboard and mouse ports. And of course the power jack on the back there. There's an information plate, custom manufactured in the USA by Tandy Corporation, Fort Worth, Texas. That's the catalog number 25-1451. And it only uses 44 watts from the wall because the power supply in this is only rated for 25 watts total output. That's all it needs. After removing the cover, you can see just how little there is inside this thing. There's the power supply up against the side here, so you can see there's no fan. There's the motherboard. This is basically what would be used in a laptop, except it was put in a desktop case. So it's very advanced circuitry for the time, a lot of surface mount chips. Now this is the 512K RAM built in, and these two chips expanded to 768K. Now the memory above 640K is not used by DOS, it's used for video memory. And here is also that clock battery that the hard drive model came with. There's the clock chip itself, a Dallas DS1215 for the external crystal. You can see the solder pads where the non-hard drive version would have the plug-in module instead of the chip built in. And here's that one 8-bit ISA slot on its side. There's the built-in speaker facing downwards, and here's the floppy drive and hard drive, and you can see the floppy drive gets its power through the cable. That was typical for Tandy computers at the time. That floppy drive is a TIAC FD235F. And here's the hard drive, which also connects to the circuit board here through a very short little cable, but it does have a regular Molex type power connector. The hard drive is a Seagate ST351A/X because this is an IDE XT interface, so you need this kind of special hard drive which supports the IDE XT interface. I believe Western Digital, Seagate, and Miniscribe all made hard drives for IDE XT. The CPU chip is actually one of the smallest things on the whole board. It's an AMD 8086-1, which is rated for 10 MHz. Here it's running at 9.54 MHz. And towards the back you can see a riser card that they put in to give you those extra ports on the top here. And there's one jumper on the riser card which lets you select what kind of audio input you want to have, either a microphone input or a line level audio input through the microphone port. It looks like the chipset on the motherboard was actually made by NCR, because I see NCR on a lot of these chips here. See, NCR, NCR. Well, that's actually a Zilog, which is interesting. But upside down there you can see NCR, so it looks like National Cash Register had some involvement in the design of this motherboard. That's actually the floppy drive controller made by Zilog. You can also see how clean and dust-free everything stays inside here because there is no fan constantly drawing air through it. So that's another advantage of the fanless design. It stays nice and clean inside. I now have a different monitor set up to show you the Hercules monochrome graphics mode. And right now you're also seeing the screensaver built into DeskMate. I have it set to go blank after 10 minutes, so just push any key and we get our screen back. This is actually a color monitor, but it also supports the monochrome scan rate, which is why it's able to work here. So you can see the graphics are vector graphics, so they scale to the higher resolution compared to CGA. Maybe you could hear that the hard drive also shuts down after 10 minutes. That's one of the features of the IDE standard that this was able to do. Another thing worth showing about DeskMate is that you can get a view of the directory structure and use it as a file manager. Like I can go into this directory here and select files and copy them and so on and so forth. So it's not just a menu system, you can actually use it to manage your files. And then you just click on menus here and it gets back to the desktop. There's also a way to set up the hardware parameters of this computer from within DeskMate. Like you could switch it between color and monochrome. You can have the memory check on startup enabled or disabled. You can tell it to start from ROM or from disk. And all sorts of things like that. So right now I'll switch it to color and save that. It says you need to reboot, so I'll reboot. I'll just exit out of this and then exit out DeskMate. And I'll hit Control Delete. And it comes up now in CGA mode. You can see it turned white. And we have colors. You can also switch between color and monochrome modes from the keyboard by pressing Control Alt Shift V, and that makes it reboot and switches it back to monochrome mode here. So that's your look at the software and hardware of the Tandy 1000RL from 1990. Now Tandy had two following models which used this same kind of slimline case. There was a 1000RLX, which used a 10 MHz 286 processor and VGA graphics, and finally the 1000RSX, which had a 386SX processor and was the only member of the Tandy 1000 series which could run Windows 3.1 in 386 enhanced mode.